Coset's and Lagrange's theorem. Definition of a coset. Now we'll define what is a coset. Let H be a subgroup of a group G and A belongs to G, then any set of the type small a into capital H is equals to the set of all elements small a into small h such that H belongs to capital H is called a left coset of H in G generated by the element A. And remember that the element A is from G and small h is from capital H. And the product of small a and every element of H is denoted by a set, namely small a into H, that is called left coset of H in G generated by A. This is called left coset because the A is in the left of capital H, therefore it's called a left coset of H, and the element small a into H must be in G, therefore left coset of H in G, and we get this set by multiplying each and every element of capital H by A, therefore it is called generated by A. That is, the elements A into H is generated by the elements the element small a which is in G, and hence it is called a left coset of H in G generated by A. And the set H into small a is equals to the set of all elements of the form H into small a such that small h belongs to capital H is called a right coset of H in G generated by A. It is called a right coset because the A is in the right of capital H and the elements are in G. The elements H into A, they are all in G. Also, the set of elements H into A is obtained by multiplying by small a, therefore we say is generated by A, and hence H into A is called right coset of H in G generated by A. Also, small a into capital H, comma capital H into A are called cosets of H generated by A in G. Note, if H is a subgroup of a group G, then H is left coset as well as right coset. H is a left coset because E into H is equals to the set of all elements small e into small h where small e is the identity element in G and small h is from capital H. We know that E into H is H because E is the identity, therefore that is equal to the set of elements H where H is from capital H, which means we are writing all the elements of H here in the set form. Therefore, this is nothing but capital H. Similarly, it can be proved that H into small e equals to capital H. Therefore, if H is a subgroup of a group G, then left coset is equal to right coset is equals to capital H. Remember that small a into capital H is called left coset. Capital H into A is called right coset, whereas here H itself is left coset as well as right coset of H. Note 2, left coset, namely A into capital H intersection H into A is non-empty because at least the element A will be there in both AH and HA. If G is abelian, then the left coset is equals to right coset generated by A. For any H belongs to capital H, small a H is equal to small h into a, because h is abelian, a belongs to g, therefore a into h is in g. Similarly, h into a is also in g, and since g is abelian, a h is equal to h a. This implies a into capital H is equals to capital H into a. Therefore, if the group g is abelian, then there is no difference between left coset and the right coset of h in g generated by any element a of g. So there is no distinction between left coset and the right coset of h in g. Left or right cosets of any subgroup in a group is a group is also called residue class modulo the subgroup after the group. If the operation in G is denoted additively, that is the operation is addition, then the left coset of H in G generated by A denoted by small a plus capital H, because here plus is the binary operation, whereas here multiplication is the binary operation. Therefore, we have a into h, but here we have small a plus capital H, where small a plus capital H is equal to the set of elements a plus h, where h is from capital H and small a is from capital G. Similarly, the right coset of H in G generated by A is denoted by H plus A, and H plus A is equals to the set of elements H plus A such that H belongs to capital H. If A belongs to H, in the definition of left coset or right coset, the small a is from capital G. Suppose if small a is from capital H, then what happens? Then the left coset of H in G generated by A is same as the subgroup capital H, that is also equals to H into small a, that is the right coset of H in G generated by A. That is, if A is from H, then there is no difference between left coset and right coset and the group H itself. Remember that if G is abelian, there is no difference between left coset of H in G or right coset of H in G. Both are one and the same. If A belongs to H, here also there is no difference between left coset and the right coset. Both are is equals to the subgroup H itself. Example, G is equal to the set 1 comma minus 1 comma I comma minus I is a group with respect to multiplication. Let us take capital H is equals to the set 1 comma minus 1. This is a subgroup of G. Let us find all the left and the right cosets of H in G generated by the element of G. The first one, left coset of H generated by the element of G in G, that is small a into H. Here small a takes the value of 1 minus 1 I minus I. Let us take a equals to 1. When you take a equal to 1, a into H becomes 1 into H. That is, we have to multiply each and every element of H by 1. Therefore, 1 into H is equals to the set 1 into 1 comma 1 into minus 1. That is equals to 1 comma minus 1. 1 comma minus 1 is nothing but H itself. Let us call this 1 H as capital A. Let us take A equals to minus 1, the second element. Therefore, minus 1 into H will be equals to the set minus 1 comma 1. This is also same as H. Let us call this minus 1 into H as B. Let us take the third element, namely A equals to I. We take A equals to I, we have I into H. That is, we have to multiply each and every one element of H by I. That is equals to I into 1, comma I into minus 1 is equals to the set I comma minus I, we call it as C. Now let us take the fourth element of G, namely minus I. Let small a equals to minus I. Now we have to multiply each and every element of H by minus I. Therefore 1 into minus I, minus I into minus 1. And while writing this 1 minus 1 I minus I, it must be left of the elements of H, because we are going to find the left coset. Therefore order is important here. So minus I into 1 comma minus I into minus 1 is equals to minus I comma I. Let us call it as D. Now we are going to find the right coset of H in G generated by the element of G. Let A equals to 1. H into 1 is equals to, we have to multiply each and every element of H by 1. That is, we have to multiply the post multiplied by 1. Therefore 1 into 1 minus 1 into 1, that is equal to 1 comma minus 1. 1 comma minus 1 is nothing but the set or the subgroup H itself, that is equals to E. We call it as E. Now let us take the second element, minus 1. Now we have to multiply each and every element of H by minus 1. Therefore post multiplied by minus 1. So 1 into minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1, that is equal to minus 1 comma 1 equal to H. We call it as F. Now take the third element, namely I. So A equals to I. When you take A equal to I, the right coset of H in G generated by I is equals to 1 into I comma minus 1 into I. That is, we post multiply each and every element of H by I. Therefore 1 into I is I, minus 1 into I is minus I equal to, let us call it as J. Take the fourth element, A equals to minus I. When A equals to minus I, the right coset of H in G generated by minus I will be H into minus I, and this can be obtained by post multiply each and every element of H with minus I. Therefore 1 into minus I comma minus 1 into minus I, that is equal to minus I comma I. Let us call this set as K. Thus we have four left cosets of H in G generated by the elements of G, as well as four right cosets of H in G generated by the elements of G. A, B, C and D are the four left cosets of H in G, and E, F, J, K are the four right cosets of H in G. Now we'll have some observations from the above example. It's meant for only a finite group. G equals to 1 comma minus 1, I comma minus I has four elements, and the subgroup H is equals to 1 comma minus 1 has two elements. The first observation is there are four left cosets and four right cosets of H in G, because every element of G generates one left coset and one right coset of H in G. Therefore, the number of left coset or right coset is equals to number of elements in G. In the above example, A, B, C, D are four left cosets. E, F, J, K are the four right cosets of H in G. But there are only two distinct left cosets, namely the set 1 comma minus 1 and the set I comma minus I, and two distinct right cosets of H in G. Here A equals to B, namely 1 comma minus 1, C equal to D, namely I comma minus I. Similarly, E equals to F, that is equals to 1 comma minus 1, and J equals to K, that is equal to I comma minus I. Therefore, there are four left cosets, four right cosets, but among them only two are distinct. Therefore, number of left cosets equal to number of right cosets is equals to number of elements in G. Number of elements in each left or right coset is equals to n of k, because k has only two elements. Therefore, number of elements in each left or right coset will be n of h. Number of distinct left cosets is equals to number of distinct right cosets is equals to n of h. Thus, number of left cosets equal to number of right coset is equal to n of g. Number of elements in each left coset or right coset is equals to number of distinct left coset is equal to number of distinct right coset is equal to n of h. The second observation is, every left or right coset has exactly two elements, that is equal to n of h. So, number of elements in a left coset of h in g equal to number of elements in a right coset of h in g. That is, every left or right coset of h in g has same number of elements and is equals to number of elements in h. The third point is, clearly A equals to B, that is equal to 1 comma minus 1, and the set C equals to D, that is equal to I comma minus I. That is, we have only two distinct left cosets of h in g and their union is g. That is, g equals to 1 comma minus 1 I comma minus I, that is equals to the set 1 comma minus 1 union the set I comma minus I. That is, g is the union of all distinct left cosets of h in g, or union of all distinct right cosets of h in g. Also, the number of elements in g equals to, that is equal to 4, number of distinct left or right cosets of h in g, that is 2, number of elements in 2, that is 2, that is equal to 4 is equal to 2 into 2. And this result is very important results. This we are going to use in one of the important theorems. Number of elements in G is equals to number of distinct left or distinct right cosets of H in G into number of elements in H. That's the result. N of G equals to number of distinct left or right cosets of H in G into number of elements in H. The fourth observation is, among the eight sets, A equals to B equal to E equals to F is equals to H. And these four sets A, B, E and F, each is equal to H. That is, 1 into H is equal to minus 1 into H is equal to H. That is equal to H into 1 is equal to H into minus 1. Here 1 and minus 1 are elements of H. That is, if H belongs to capital H, then small h into capital H is equals to capital H is equal to capital H into small h. That is, if any element from H, then the left cosets and the right cosets of H in G generated by the same element is equals to the subgroup H itself. Fifth one. Note that I into H is equals to the set I comma minus 1, and capital H into I is equals to the set I comma minus I. This shows that A into H intersection H into A is non-empty. This is the left coset, this is the right coset generated by the same element I. Therefore, there is at least one element common in IH as well as HI. Therefore, the intersection is non-empty. That is, intersection of left coset and the right coset generated by the element A is always non-empty. Sixth point is, 1 into H is equal to H into 1. Minus 1 into H is equal to H into minus 1. I into H is equal to H into I, and minus I into H is equal to H into minus I. why this happened. Left coset generated by A equal to right coset generated by A, because G is abelian. So if G is abelian, then the left coset of H in G generated by A is equal to right coset of H in G generated by the same element A. Show that the algebraic structure 3z, plus is a subgroup of the algebraic structure z, plus. Find all the left cosets and the right cosets of the algebraic structure 3z, plus in the algebraic structure z, plus, where z is a set of integers, plus is the ordinary addition of integers. Let z be the additive group of integers. Therefore, z is equal to the set containing all the integers, all the negative integers, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, and all the positive integers, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. It contains all the negative integers, all the positive integers, including 0, where 0 is the identity in the set of integers or the group of integers. 3z is obtained by multiplying each element of z by 3. Therefore, the 3z is equal to the set containing elements, all the negative integers, multiples of 3, comma minus 9, comma minus 6, comma minus 3, 0, comma 3, comma 6, comma 9, so on. It has infinitely many elements. So 3z can be written as the set containing elements of the form 3 into n, such that n belongs to set of integers capital Z. Clearly, the algebraic structure 3z, plus is a subgroup of the algebraic structure z, plus. The reason is, for 3z is a subset of z, let us choose two elements from 3z, namely 3m, 3n, both belong to 3z, where small m and small n are integers from capital Z. We know that H is a non-empty complex of a group G, plus, then H is a subgroup of G if and only if A, B belong to H, implies A minus B belongs to H. This is one of the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty subset of a group to be a subgroup. Now, here H is nothing but 3z and G is nothing but z. We have taken two elements from H, A, B. Here A is 3n, B is 3m, both are from the set 3z. Now, we have to show that the difference of 3n and 3m must belong to 3z. Therefore, consider 3n minus 3m, that is equals to 3 into n minus m. 3 equals to 3, but n and m are integers. Difference of two integers is again an integer, and hence n minus m belongs to set of integers. That is, 3 into n minus m belongs to 3 into capital Z. Therefore, by this theorem, 3z is a subgroup of Z. Now, let us find all the right cosets of 3z. Let us find all the right cosets of 3z, plus. Let us take H is equals to 3z. That is equals to the set containing all the multiples of 3. That is minus 9, minus 6, minus 3, 0, 3, 6, 9, so on. Let us call this 3z as H. That is, we are going to find all the right cosets of H. 0 belongs to G. Therefore, H plus 0 equals to the set containing elements 9, minus 9, minus 6, minus 3, 0, 3, 9, so on. Because if we add H to 0, we get the same thing. A plus 0 is A. Therefore, H plus 0 is H only, though we write same element. Because minus 9 plus 0 is minus 9. minus 6 plus 0 is minus 6, minus 3 plus 0 is minus 3, 0 plus 0 is 0, 3 plus 0 is 3, 6 plus 0 is 6, 9 plus 0 is 9, therefore h plus 0 is nothing but h. Let us take 1 belongs to g. Here we are taking g as set of integers, capital H as 3z. So h plus 1 is equals to minus 9 plus 1 is minus 8, minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5, minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2, 0 plus 1 is 1, 3 plus 1 is 4, 6 plus 1 is 7, 9 plus 1 is 10, so on. 2 belongs to G, that is 2 is from set of integers, therefore h plus 2 is equals to, now we have to add 2 to each and every element of h, that is equal to 3z. Therefore, minus 9 plus 2 is minus 7, minus 6 plus 2 is minus 4, minus 3 plus 2 is minus 1, 0 plus 2 is 2, 3 plus 2 is 5, 6 plus 2 is 8, 9 plus 2 is 11, so on. Similarly, h plus 3 equals to minus 6, minus 9, 0, 3, 6, 9, 12, so on. And remember that this is same as h plus 0. Minus 6, minus 9, 0, 3, 6, 9, 12, so on. Now 4 belongs to G. That is 4 is an element of Z, that is integer. H plus 4 is equals to, now add 4 to each and every element of 3Z, namely H, we get minus 9 plus 4 is minus 5. Minus 6 plus 4 is minus 2, 1 comma, 4 comma, 7, 10, so on. Now we go to negative integers. Take minus 1 from z, that is equal to g. Therefore, h plus minus 1. Now we have to add minus 1 to each and every element of 3z, namely h. Therefore, minus 9 plus minus 1 is minus 10. Minus 6 plus minus 1 is minus 7. Minus 3 plus minus 1 is minus 4. 0 plus minus 1 is minus 1. 3 plus minus 1 is 2. 6 plus minus 1 is 5. 9 plus minus 1 is 8. So on. Let us take minus 2 belongs to G. Therefore, H plus minus 2 will be the set containing elements minus 11, minus 8, minus 5, minus 2, 1 comma, 4 comma, 7 comma, so on. So from this we see that h plus 0 is exactly same as h. That is also same as h plus 3 is equals to h plus 6, so on. Now h plus minus 2. This h plus minus 2, which contains elements minus 11, minus 8, minus 5, minus 2, 1, 4, 7. These elements are there in h plus 1. Look at this h plus 1. 1, 4, 7, 10, minus 2, minus 5, minus 8. Therefore, h minus 2 is same as h plus 1. Similarly, is equal to h plus 4. H plus 4. H plus 4 and h minus 2 both are the same set. That is equal to h plus 7. This we are adding plus 6, that's it. H plus 0 equal to h. H plus 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. Minus 2 plus 3 is 1. 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. So on. Now, h plus 2. That contains elements minus 7, minus 4, minus 1, 2, 5, 6, 11, so on. That is same as h plus minus 1. That is minus 4, minus 1, 2, 5, 8, 11, so on. That is also equal to h plus 5, so on. We are adding plus 3 because this is multiples of 3. Therefore, h plus 3 plus 3 is 6. 1, 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 3 is 7, 2 plus 3 is 5, so on. In this way, we get only 3 distinct right cosets, namely h plus 0, h plus 1, h plus 2, such that g is the union of all the 3 right cosets, namely h plus 0 union h plus 1 union h plus 2. If we add these 3 sets, h plus 0, h plus 1, h plus 2, we get the elements of G. That is, G contains elements, nothing but all the integers. Here you can see here, say 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, all the positive integers. Similarly, we have a negative integers. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, so on. So, they all have all the negative integers. These are all negative integers. And these are all positive integers. These are all positive integers, including 0. Therefore, this G is nothing but union of H plus 0, H plus 1 and H plus 2. Since G is abelian, left coset of H in G generated by an element A is equal to right coset of H in G generated by the element A. Similarly, 0 plus H is equal to H, equal to 3 plus H, equal to 6 plus H. Minus 2 plus h is equal to 1 plus h, equal to 4 plus h, equal to 7 plus h. Minus 1 plus h is equal to 2 plus h, equal to 5 plus h, so on. These are all right cosets, these are all left cosets. Now, definition of index of h in G. If h is a subgroup of a finite group G, then the number of left or right cosets of H in G is called index of H in G. Definition of index of H in G. If H is a subgroup of a finite group G, then the number of left or right cosets of H in G is called the index of H in G. Now we are going to prove very important theorem, namely Lagrange's theorem. The statement of this theorem is, the order of a subgroup of a finite group divides the order of the group. Proof, let G be a finite group of order n. That is, it contains n elements. Therefore, O of G equals to n. Let H be a subgroup of G of order m. That is, H contains m elements. And hence, this n is greater than or equal to m. Therefore, order of H is equals to m. Now, we have to show that m divides n. Let K be the number of distinct left cosets of H in G. Since each left coset of H in G contains the same number of elements and G is the union of all distinct left cosets of H in G, we have the result, namely number of elements in G equals to number of distinct left cosets of H in G into number of elements in each left coset of H in G. Here is an example. The number of distinct left cosets equal to number of distinct right cosets equals to n of H. A number of elements in each or left coset is equals to n of h. Therefore, this number of elements in G is n, that is O of G equal to n. Number of distinct left cosets of h in G is taken as k. Therefore, k into number of elements in each left coset of h in G is same as number of elements in H, that is M. This implies K equals to N by M. Here N, M, K, they are all integers. Since K is a positive integer, because K is the number of distinct left cosets, the number is always positive, and hence m divides n. That is, m is nothing but order of h that divides order of g.